Sue Simmons.
Right,
well, maybe that's where you can just flash. Okay. Now, we want to bring our next guest on, who is a very well-known in New York also, but in New York City. He has his own program. He's known as the telepsychic. And his name is Mr. Morris Fonte. Yes. Some of the psychics actually do that voice vibrations. Do you do that?
Yeah. Like voice vibrations, like
how did you find out that you had this psychic? Someone who's also Sue Simmons also up and has David Lennon come down the hall. And you were on David Lennon,
of course. Thank you.
this was going by, this is 1971. Okay, there he is right there. Okay, now we're going to bring out our last guest to this is special to my soul. Just as a little introduction, I just have to find it here. While I'm setting up, I said if you did something on the Bill Abbott flag show, what would you think?
Was that on this particular day, I don't want to buy
from you. Oh, it's good. I have
the same stuff. There's some days when you have one of these great programs, what is, if I'm doing a commercial break, I happen to get an inch in the back of my neck, and I stress, and then Tom and his sons, the same, I was supposed to be on the day, so I went, but the whole thing moved, you know? So,
Now, you work at a Valentine as well as being thank you. I was down the other trip to Minnesota. I've always wanted him to talk, but he feels that maybe he just feels I'm doing a good job, so that's why he never says anything. If you don't talk, then we don't know. Do you ever have guests like David the Simmons on the show?
Occasionally.
Don't talk.
Oh, yes, occasionally.
And they're very boring and
gives me more chance to talk.
That's the way I should look at it. I don't get to talk. David talk like wolves. They talk and we have to talk.
Now, if you
want to
say it now, I
will. See, everything's coming together now, but everything's not complete, of course. Our lovable Joey, the monk, and he's going to be dancing today to a special song with two of our favorite fans, the Sunshine. Thank you for the music.
Sandy Hook. News
4 in New York, we know all the places. News 4 in New York, we never miss a spot. News 4 in New York, we cover the bases. News 4 in New York, we know where it's hot. We know where it's hot. News 4, the people up in Harlem. News 4, Glen Cove and Yorktown Heights. News 4, Astoria and Dumont. News 4, for all you Jerseyites. News 4 in New York, we know all the places. News 4 in New York, we never miss a spot. News 4 in New York, we cover the bases. News 4 in New York, we know where it's hot. We know where it's hot. News 4! Ding, ding, ding.
Several places in the United States, in the metropolitan area,
and
San Francisco, Santa Cruz, where we've had musical soul festival.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so a whole bunch of people playing the musical soul.
We are not many.
Oh,
just a handful of people around the world.
Okay. Now, Ms. Simmons, now again, the musical soul, you didn't hear much of that growing up with your father or.
Well, you know, he played a bass fiddle, and he had a bow. So there were times where there were similarities.
Okay.
In the sound.
And did your father play Around the World in 80 Days, too?
I never heard him play that. I think this is the best rendition I've heard, though.
Okay. Yes, Ms. Greenhouse, please.
Can you tell me, the sound is made by bending the saw rather than by the application of the bow. Is that correct?
It's
bend
by bending.
You bend it at the
a different degree of flex. And by rubbing the bow against the smooth side of the saw, there's a friction that goes on there. The sound just comes out.
Is everybody fascinated by what got him interested in playing this particular
instrument?
When I was a boy in Guyana, I read of this unusual creative art. I became interested, tried the thing out, and within one day, I was playing percussion style. That is where I started. Then I progressed to the bow.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And David, do you have any questions? Since everyone's asking questions of our guest, Mr. Fonte, do you play any musical instruments? Or
no, I don't play any.
Oh, but
I love music.
Now, have you had any? You go on live with your show. Have you had any embarrassing moments over the years?
When I first started, people used to call up and ask embarrassing questions at that time. But I became a little bit more, careful.
Greenhouse has been very active with AFTRI. It's quite the union.
The American Federation of Television and Radio Artists.
Yes. All members of the union, that's right. Yes, I am. I have been, and I continue to be, and very proudly so.
Okay, and anything we can look forward to seeing you in soon?
Oh, if only I knew. I did do Guiding Light recently. I did do a play in Edinburgh this summer.
Oh.
Any commercials?
Is that in New Jersey?
Yeah. Okay, there is.
Okay. All right,
because I want it.
And Morris, and we'll keep seeing you doing your show.
Yeah, and every Sunday from 7 to 8.
Okay.
I would like to be a guest on my show.
Oh, I'd love to come on. Fonte to come on to host the show together. Okay. And that's Ms. Simmons. Excuse me.
Oh,
thank you.
Fine.
Thank you for coming
in.
A very busy day. You have to go back and do your newscast.
On my way back to the event.
Thank you for staying with us.
Right.
And Mr. Josiah, thank you for joining us. And David, thank you.
Thank you, David.
We're very grateful. And Mark and Sharon, do you have anything coming up? About the baby.
Is that your first job?
Yes.
So we're very excited about it.
And you haven't shown your Simpsons T-shirt yet. Maybe if you show those, look it back. All right. And last things to show very quickly. It's the ET finger, and we have to wrap up. So let's close with Telly Savalas.
You and me.